Hello everyone. Physics always sweet. I welcome everyone to watch this session. CBSE Class 12 Physics Chapter 9 Ray Optics and Optical Instruments Part 2. Already we have discussed Part 1 in the previous video. In this part, we will discuss just three topics. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. Within few minutes, we will complete. What are the three topics? Sign convention, focal length of mirror, and mirror equation. The first topic, sign convention. Already we have studied in class 10. Just remember, can we go for quick revision? In this, just 4 points. Left, right, up, down. For better understanding, we can go for Cartesian coordinate. Just look at the graph sheet, you can understand. The distance measured in the same direction as the direction of incident light taken as positive. It means right side of x-axis. The distance measured in the direction opposite to the direction of incident light taken as negative. It means left side of x-axis. Distance measured upward and perpendicular to the principal axis taken as positive. It means above the x-axis. Distance measured downward and perpendicular to the principal axis are taken as negative. It means below x-axis. Maybe this picture helps to remember very clearly about sign convention. Next, focal length. Already we have studied about focal length and relationship between radius of curvature and focal length. It means capital R is equal to 2f. In this 12th standard, we are going to derive and prove this relationship. Consider a ray parallel to the principal axis striking the mirror at point M. Afterwards, it is reflected through capital F. According to law of reflection, there are 2 points. The first one, in between incident ray and reflected ray, there will be a normal line. The second point, angle of incidence and angle of reflection, always it is equal, I is equal to R. From these 2 points, we are going to find out how R is equal to 2F. It means radius of curvature is equal to twice of focal length. For that, we need some mathematical background. Try to remember 2 mathematical rules. First, alternate interior angles. The second, exterior angle of triangle. What is meant by alternate interior angles? The angles which are formed inside the 2 parallel lines when intersected by a transversal are equal to its alternate pairs. These angles are called alternate interior angles. It means angle A is equal to angle D and angle B is equal to angle C. If we apply this rule in this diagram, we can get the theta value here itself. What is mean by exterior angle? If we have a triangle and tangent line, we can get the exterior angle. An exterior angle of a triangle is equal to sum of the 2 opposite interior angles. We can get the exterior angle here. Theta plus theta, 2 theta. If we apply this rule in this diagram, we can get the 2 theta value here itself. Theta plus theta, 2 theta. Just one more point we should know. In this concave mirror, we will get curved inwards surface. So, for the further step, we may draw a straight line from point M to principal axis. This touching point is capital D. Now, we can easily go into derivative part. 80% over, be cool. Look at the triangles MCD and MFD. These are right angle triangles. In these, FD is nothing but focal length. Actually, FP is focal length, but for our simplification, approximately we have taken FD. In this triangle, FD is base. So, for the solving, we can use cos theta or tan theta. If we use tan theta, we can easily derive. Already we know about tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. From first triangle MCD, tan theta is equal to MD by CD. From second triangle MFD, tan 2 theta is equal to MD by FD. For small theta value, we can take tan theta is equal to theta. Likewise, tan 2 theta is equal to 2 theta. So, this one becomes this one. So, instead of tan theta, we may apply theta. So, theta is equal to MD by CD. Likewise, this equation becomes this. Instead of tan 2 theta, we may apply 2 theta. So, 2 theta is equal to MD by FD. Based on these two equations, we may compare. We may apply the first one. We may substitute the first one in equation 2. When we compare these two ratios, so we are going to substitute the first one in 2. See, instead of these theta, we are going to apply MD by CD. So, the second equation, 2 theta is equal to MD by FD. Instead of theta, MD by CD is equal to MD by FD. MD, MD, we can cancel. And remaining 2 by CD is equal to 1 by FD. And we may take reciprocal, CD by 2, FD by 1, anything by 1, FD. CD is nothing but capital R in our diagram. And 2, FD is nothing but small f is nothing but focal length in our diagram. Now, R is equal to 2F. We got it. We proved R is equal to 2F. After this focal length, we can go for mirror equation. Already we have studied about mirror equation in class 10. 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. In this 12th standard, we are going to derive this formula. How we got this formula? For this derivation, we need to remember ray diagram rules. Four rules. What are they? The first rule. If the light ray passes parallel to the principal axis, it will be reflected through F. And then second rule, if the light ray passes through C, and then reflection will be through C. And then third rule, if the light ray passes through F, and the reflection will be parallel to the principal axis. And then fourth rule, if the light ray strikes on pole, it follows law of reflection. Look at this diagram. AB is object. It is kept at beyond C. According to ray diagram rules, we can get the image A dash, B dash between C and F. And you know about object distance U, image distance V, and focal length small f. And P is the pole of the mirror. And MN is the two ending of concave mirror. Here, we are using concave mirror. We can use convex mirror also. Before moving to derivation, we should remember lower class mathematics. That is nothing but similar triangle properties. According to similar triangle properties, corresponding sides are in proportions. It means AB by DE is equal to BC by EF is equal to AC by DF. Applying this mathematical property in this diagram, we can derive properly. Consider the two triangles A dash, B dash, F and MPF. Both are similar triangles, right angle triangle. This MP is not exactly straight line. We may consider as a straight line. From these similar triangles, we can get the proportions B dash, A dash, by PM is equal to B dash F by FP. So B dash A dash by PM is equal to B dash F by FP. Otherwise, we may change this equation like this. B dash A dash by BA. Why? Because PM is equal to BA. So this is the first equation from these similar triangles. And in this, we have one more similar triangles. A dash, B dash, P and ABP. From these, we can get the proportions B dash A dash by BA is equal to B dash P by BP. This is the second equation. If we compare these 1 and 2, we can get the answer. Before comparing these two equations, already we know about U, V, F. Here, B dash P is equal to V and FP is equal to small f and BP is equal to U. According to sign convention, U, V, F, all the three gets negative sign because all the three in minus x axis side. Otherwise, measuring these distances from pole is opposite to the direction of light. If we compare equation 1 and 2, we will get this equation. From equation 1 and 2, left sides are equal, so right sides also should be equal. So we have got this equation. We may change this equation. B dash F, B dash P minus FP. We can extend this step into this step by using diagram. So this is the equation 3. From this equation 3, we can apply U, V, F value. B dash P minus V minus FP minus F, FP minus F, B dash P minus V, BP minus U. Y minus according to sign convention. Minus V minus into minus plus F by minus F is equal to minus V by minus U. Minus minus cancel, so we may rewrite this. So this equation will become, this side become plus V by plus U. And we may just rewrite plus F minus V by minus F. If we multiply with minus 1, this numerator and denominator, we will get this one. F becomes minus F, minus V becomes plus V, minus F becomes plus F is equal to V by U. So we may rewrite V minus F by plus F is equal to V by U. V by F minus F by F, because F is common. So we may classify, we may separate this ratio. So V by F minus F by F is equal to V by U. V by F minus F cancel. So minus 1 is equal to V by U. So V by F is equal to, we may shift this minus 1 to this side. So V by F is equal to plus 1. So plus 1 plus V by U. From the above equation, if we divide by V, we can get 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. So we have got it, mirror equation. And last but not least, magnification. We have studied about magnification in 10th standard itself. M is equal to H dash by H and M is equal to minus B by U. These formulas we have studied, but we don't know how we have got this formula. So we can derive using the second equation. So in this mirror equation, this is the second. B dash A dash by BA is equal to B dash P by BP. From the second equation, we may derive M is equal to minus V by U. So using diagram, we can get by b dash a dash is equal to minus h dash, b a is equal to plus h is equal to b dash p is equal to minus v, b p is equal to minus u. If we need clarification how we substitute these h and minus h dash instead of these, you better go to the diagram. So minus minus cancel, so v by u is equal to h dash by h is nothing but m magnification minus sign. So minus m is equal to v by u, otherwise m is equal to minus v by u. We prove. That's all, over. I hope everyone enjoyed this session. Thank you so much. We will meet with the next topic, refraction. Bye-bye.